Hi, I'm Matt from Duo Security. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install and configure Duo Single Sign-On. Duo Single Sign-On is a cloud-hosted SAML identity provider that adds two-factor authentication, including inline self-enrollment and the Duo prompt, to popular cloud services like Salesforce and Amazon Web Services using SAML 2.0 federation.
Duo Single Sign-On is available to all non-federal customers on Duo MFA, Duo Access, or Duo Beyond Edition. Before watching this video, please be sure to read the documentation for Duo Single Sign-On at duo.com/docs/SSO. When you finish configuring Duo Single Sign-On, you can set up a cloud-hosted portal called Duo Central that your users can visit to get access to all of your organization's applications and links. Visit the Duo Central documentation at duo.com/docs/duo-central for more information. This video will only cover setting up Duo Single Sign-On.
Duo Single Sign-On is a cloud-hosted SAML 2.0 identity provider that secures access to cloud applications with your user's existing directory credentials like Microsoft Active Directory or Google Apps accounts. SAML delegates authentication from a service provider to an identity provider, also known as an IDP, and is used for single sign-on solutions, also known as SSO. Duo provides SAML connectors for enterprise cloud applications like Amazon Web Services, Salesforce, and Cisco ASA. Duo Single Sign-On also offers a generic connector with the ability to provide your own SAML metadata and connect to most apps that support the SAML 2.0 standard. Protected cloud applications redirect your users to Duo Single Sign-On. Your users are then authenticated using your existing primary authentication source for credential verification and then prompted for two-factor authentication before being allowed to access the SAML application. Duo Single Sign-On supports local Active Directory or SAML IDPs as identity sources.
Before you set up Duo Single Sign-On, note that you will need the following: a Duo Administrator with the Owner role, an Active Directory, also known as AD, or SAML IDP that can be used as your primary authentication source, and a web application that can act as a SAML service provider that can be protected by Duo Single Sign-On. In this video, we will use AD as the primary authentication source and will protect Salesforce. Since we are going to use AD, we will also need at least one Windows or Linux server that can communicate with the AD, service account credentials for AD, and the ability to add DNS records to the domains related to the user's email addresses listed in AD.
Log in to the Duo admin panel. In the left sidebar, click Single Sign-On. If this is your first time setting up Duo Single Sign-On, you will need to review and agree to specific Duo Single Sign-On terms. Review the information on the page. If you agree to the terms, check the box and then click Activate and Start Setup.
You will be redirected to the Customize Your SSO subdomain page. You can specify a subdomain you would like your users to see when they are logging in with Duo Single Sign-On. Click Save and Continue to use the chosen subdomain. After entering your chosen subdomain, click Confirm in the prompt that appears. You will be redirected to the Add Authentication Source page. You can choose between using AD or a SAML IDP as your authentication source. In this video, we will use AD. At the bottom of the Active Directory section, click the Add button. You will need to install and configure an on-premises Duo authentication proxy to connect to Duo Single Sign-On. Duo Single Sign-On is compatible with Duo Authentication Proxy versions 3.2.2 or higher. For the sake of brevity, this video assumes that you have already installed the authentication proxy on a Windows system that can communicate with your AD and that you are familiar with the proxy configuration file. You can read about how to install and configure the proxy on duo.com/docs/authproxy-reference. It is recommended to use three proxies for high availability. Before proceeding, confirm that your proxy can communicate with your AD domain controllers and that the proxy has outbound internet access over port 443. For ease of setup, we recommend accessing the Duo Single Sign-On section of the admin panel from the system that your authentication proxy has been installed on. navigate to your new Active Directory Authentication Source configuration page. On the Active Directory Configuration section, under Install the Authentication Proxy, click Add Authentication Proxy. You will be redirected to a new page. Ensure that the Windows tab is selected.
Locate and open the Authentication Proxy configuration file. In the Duo Admin panel, click the button to copy the SSO section and service account credentials for the proxy. Paste this section into the bottom of your configuration file.
You may then need to populate the service account username and service account password parameters with the credentials for a service account in your Active Directory. You do not need to do this if your Windows authentication proxy is domain joined and you plan to use integrated authentication. Since our system is domain joined and we are going to use integrated, we will leave those parameters commented out. Save and close the configuration file. In the Connect the Authentication Proxy to Duo section, copy the unique command provided and run it in a command prompt with administrator permissions. Under Verify the Proxy is Connected, click Run Test. This test will confirm that your proxy is connected to Duo. If you encounter any issues, check the proxy logs. You can add additional proxies by repeating these steps. Next, configure your authentication source. You can do this from any system that can access the Duo Admin panel. Back on the Active Directory configuration page, scroll down to the Configure Active Directory section and select or enter your configuration options.
In the Domain Controller section, enter the hostname or IP and port of your Active Directory domain controller.
The port is typically 389 for ClearText LDAP or Start TLS and 636 for LDAP-S. Duo recommends at least 3 domain controllers for high availability. You can add additional domain controllers by clicking Add Domain Controller. In the Base DN section, enter the DN that corresponds to a container or OU in your directory structure containing the user accounts for SSO. You can add additional DNs by clicking Add Base DN. In the Authentication Type section, select the type of authentication you would like to perform with your Active Directory. Integrated performs Windows authentication from a domain joined system. Plain performs username password authentication. NTLM V1 and NTLM V2 also perform username password authentication with additional options for the directory domain and workstation. In this video, we will use Integrated. The transport type determines how the connection between the Duo authentication proxy and the Active Directory domain controller server are encrypted. The default, clear, is unencrypted. Select Start TLS or LDAP-S to encrypt LDAP authentication traffic. If you select Start TLS or LDAP-S, you will need to provide the certificate chain for your directory server's SSL certificate as the SSL CA certs. In this example, we will use clear. In the email attributes field, enter all attributes that could contain a user's email address. This email will also be used for Duo two-factor authentication. You can add additional attributes by clicking Add Attribute. In this example, we will leave the default of just the mail attribute. By default, the email address that users type in during login will be used to match them in Duo. If their email address does not match their Duo username, you can check the box next to Specify Duo Username attribute and type in the name of an Active Directory attribute that should be used instead to match against in Duo. The Username Normalization option is similar to Username Normalization on most application pages in the Duo Admin panel. This setting controls whether the username sent to Duo from your Active Directory is normalized based on the format of the username. The default is simple, and we will leave this set to simple in our example. Duo Single Sign-On requires that you verify control of the email domains users will be logging in with by adding a DNS text record to the domain's DNS. This step is to protect users from accidentally exposing their credentials to a Duo Single Sign-On not owned by their organization. Under the Permitted Email Domain section of the Active Directory configuration page, locate the Add Email Domain field. Type in the domain name of an email address that users from your organization will log in with.
Click Add.
A table will appear showing the domain name you just added, along with additional information about the DNS text record that needs to be created. You then need to log in to your DNS provider and create a DNS text record for the domain you just added in the record name field with the value in the corresponding DNS text record value column. The documentation contains links to information about adding DNS records for popular domain registrars. Once your DNS record has been created, return to the Duo Admin panel. Under the Status column, click the Verify button. It can take time for DNS changes to propagate. If the verification fails, you may need to wait and try again later. Once the record has been verified, the Status column will change to Verified. Users using the verified domain will now be able to log in to Duo Single Sign-On. Repeat these steps for all email domains that need to be verified. Under the Test Active Directory Configuration section, click Run Tests. This will test connections between Duo Single Sign-On, your authentication proxies, and your Active Directory. It will only report the status of an individual connection if there is an error. If you encounter an error, make the appropriate changes and click Run Tests again. Click Save. You are now ready to start protecting applications with Duo Single Sign-On. When configuring an application to be protected with Duo Single Sign-On, you will need to send attributes from Duo Single Sign-On to the application. Active Directory will work with no additional setup. If you use a SAML IDP as your authentication source, you must verify that you configured it to send the correct SAML attributes. In this example, we will protect Salesforce with Duo Single Sign-On. The documentation for Salesforce is located at duo.com/docs/sso-salesforce. Salesforce SSO requires a custom domain. If you do not already have a domain for your organization, you will need to create one. In this example, we already have a custom domain. Reference the documentation for the steps to set up your custom domain. Have both the Duo Admin panel and your Salesforce site's administrative console open in a browser. From the Duo Admin panel, click Applications in the left sidebar. Then click Protect an Application.
Use the search bar to locate Salesforce with 2FA with SSO hosted by Duo, single sign-on, next to it.
Click Protect. You will be redirected to the application's configuration page. You'll need the information listed under metadata later in the setup process. Next, enable SSO in Salesforce. Our Salesforce console uses the Lightning experience. The UI differs slightly in the classic UI. Reference the documentation for more information. In your Salesforce Administrative Console, navigate to Setup, Settings, Identity, Single Sign-On Settings. Click Edit, then select the SAML Enabled option. Click Save. Click the New SAML Single Sign-On Settings button. Enter a descriptive name for the SSO configuration. Salesforce uses the name you enter here to populate the API name. Copy the issuer ID from the Duo Admin panel metadata section and paste it into the Salesforce SSO issuer field. Enter your Salesforce organization's custom domain preceded by https://, in the entity ID field.
In the Duo Admin panel, next to Identity Provider Certificate, click the button to download the Duo Single Sign-On Signing Certificate.
Upload the certificate to the Identity Provider Certificate section in Salesforce. In Salesforce, leave the Request Signing Certificate, Request Signature Method, Assertion Decryption Certificate, SAML Identity Type, SAML Identity Location, and Service Provider Initiated Request Binding Settings at their default values. Copy the Identity Provider Login URL from the Duo Admin Panel Metadata section and paste it into the Salesforce SSO Identity Provider Login URL field. Copy the Identity Provider Logout URL from the Duo Admin Panel Metadata section and paste it into the Custom Logout URL field. After you have entered all the required information, click the Save button. Make note of the entity ID and login URL as you will need to provide that information to Duo. Next, add your new Duo Single Sign-On provider to your Salesforce login page. In Salesforce, navigate to Setup, Settings, Company Settings, My Domain. Scroll down to the Authentication Configuration section of the My Domain page and click Edit. In the Authentication Service Settings section, check the box for your Duo Single Sign-On SSO configuration. Click Save. Next, update the Salesforce application in Duo. on your Salesforce application page in the Duo Admin panel, locate the Service Provider section. Copy the Entity ID from the Salesforce SAML Single Sign-On Settings Detail page and enter it into the Entity ID field in the Duo Admin panel. Copy the login URL from the Salesforce SAML Single Sign-On Settings Detail page and enter it into the Login URL field in the Duo Admin panel. Scroll to the bottom of the page and click the Save button. Finally, verify that your SSO configuration is working correctly. Navigate to your Salesforce custom domain. The login page for your domain now shows a button for Duo Single Sign-On Authentication under the traditional username and password entry fields. Click the button to be redirected to the Duo Single Sign-On login page. Log in with a username that has been enrolled in Duo. In this example, our user has also installed and activated Duo Mobile on their smartphone. You will then be redirected to the Duo prompt to complete two-factor authentication. From the prompt, the enrolled user can select Send me a push, Call me, or enter a passcode to complete two-factor authentication. In this example, we will use Duo Push. Open the notification on the smartphone, check the contextual information to confirm the login is legitimate, and tap the green button to accept. You have successfully configured Duo Single Sign-On.